Are you worried that, I guess, all of this, you know, ultra-cheap monetary policy from the European Central Bank has taken away the risks that we see in Italy and therefore in Italian politics?
To some extent, yes. The ECB made an extremely smart monetary policy, and President Draghi has been very smart in mastering the support for QE, and he still has this support. I personally believe that the phasing out will be rather quicker than slower, for some of the reasons that Professor Pissarides mentioned for the US, but also for the impact that in European countries, in Italy for sure, a very accommodating monetary policy has on the perception of the need to act on economic policy, on real policies. And I believe that among the factors which explain why the electoral promises issued so liberally and so irresponsibly by all the political parties, one of the reasons is that there is no feeling of pressure whatsoever.
But what will reality look like? So first, is there a real danger that reforms will be slow, will be lagging with whoever becomes the next prime minister in Italy? And also, there are a lot of parties offering tax cuts. How do you fund tax cuts in Italy?
Yes, well, first of all, a positive to be put on record is that no party, either populist or not, has any longer in their program the idea of leaving the euro, calling a referendum to leave the euro. They've all calmed down. But indeed, the issuance of costly promises is virtually limitless. But what will happen? I'm not too concerned that these promises will be honored. Luckily, they will not be honored. But what will be the explanation of the parties which have promised so much the day they have to cut down on promises? The culprit would be Europe, because European constraints will not allow them to fully deliver on the promises. So this is the traditional division of jobs between national politics and EU politics, except that at every round of this game, the gap between the domestic public opinion and Europe grows. And because we will have in May, we all Europeans will have in May 2019 the European elections for the European Parliament, I would not rule out that the settling down of eclectic ideas about leaving the euro, etc., might come up again with the populist parties, say 6 months from now, when the European elections approach, because then, of course, the discussion will have to be about Europe.